We didn't do anything in the match other than drop him on his head with a suplex one time, which he told me later knocked him out. And
yeah, but that was great. Just
gave him a couple of pile drivers. And as the match was over, they disqualified me. And as the match was over, he's just laying there. And so our referee, Jerry Calhoun, and then we, you know, we had to turn away crowd, 12,000 people there, and they were all up around the ring, and they were so happy that Andy had finally got what he deserved, and they're screaming and hollering, and Andy just laid there motionless like he was dead, you know.
Yeah.
So I'm walking around holding my hands up, and finally the crowd's kind of, you know, yeah, and I'm thinking, well, okay, it's time to get him up and get him back to the dressing room. So I told Calhoun, the referee, I said, all right, go over and lean over and tell Andy, you know, to help him up and get him back to his feet and get him back to the dressing room. So Calhoun walks over and he kneels down, and I'm just still walking around looking at the crowd and waving. So Calhoun, I see him talking to him. So then Calhoun comes back to me and he says, Andy says he wants an ambulance. And I said, an ambulance? He's not hurt. I said, no. I said, just go over and help him up and just tell him, you know, you get some guys to help him back. And I said, just sell, you know, act like he's hurt on the way back to the dressing room. And so Calhoun goes back over again and says, tells him, and then a minute later he comes back to me and says, really, he really says he wants an ambulance. And I said, go tell Andy that an ambulance costs about $300 to come out here. And I said, plus, where are they going to take him? They can't take him to the hospital. And I said, tell him it's too expensive. We're not going to get an ambulance, right? So Calhoun goes over and kneels down beside Andy again, and Andy's still not moving, just his mouth, he's saying a few words. And the referee comes back over to me and says, he says he'll pay for it.
Oh, God, that's great.
I said, well, okay, if he'll pay for it, tell him to call an ambulance. So next thing you know, they call the ambulance. We wait there another 15, 20 minutes. He's still there. The crowd wouldn't leave. They're all there, and he's laying there like he's dead. And his manager, George Shapiro from California, was there, and his writer, Bob Zamuda, were there by his side, and his girlfriend. And you know, and so finally in comes the ambulance. They put him on the stretcher, and they put the neck brace on him, take him to the hospital. He goes through all the tests, and he stays in the Memphis hospital for 3 days with his neck in traction.
Are you kidding me?
3 days he stayed in the hospital with his neck in traction.
Andy Kaufman shells out $300 to bring your ambulance out. You tight wads. Looking at the bottom line, don't want to spend 300 bones on an ambulance. So he's in the hospital for 3 days. And so then you go to visit him, obviously, or call him. So what do you guys do to book the next part of this?
Oh, no, I did not go to visit him at all. No, I didn't do that or call him or anything. It was just like he was there for 3 days, and then he went back to Hollywood. And the next call I get from Andy was just one day out of the blue, and he said, hey, do you want to be on the David Letterman show?